Hi everyone, it's Blesky P here from Melbourne, Australia. And let me tell you, I got the fabulous Greg Walsh. How are you today, Greg?
Hey, how you doing? Good to see you, Plastic.
That's it. That's what I want to hear. Are you feeling groovy, Greg?
Always.
That's it. That's what I want.
Hey, bananas, we think you're groovy.
We think you're groovy.
Hey, bananas, we watch a movie.
Watch a movie, yeah.
Driving dune buggies everywhere. Just going crazy without a care. Hey, bananas,
we think you're groovy.
Hey, bananas, we think you're groovy. We love to watch you because you're our favorite show.
Hey, bananas, we think you're groovy.
Hey, bananas,
hey, bananas, we think you're groovy. Hey, bananas, we think you're groovy. Na, 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 na.
All I want to say is, hey, Greg Walsh, we think you're groovy. And actually, that's my voice. I am singing on it.
That is your song?
Yeah, the US love it out there. It's great. Hey, bananas, we think you're groovy. Vicky's singing on it. It's fantastic. Now, Greg,
I love it.
You're coming in.
A little bit of Velvet Underground there.
It's more, you know, the Banana Splits?
Of course.
1968. That's a tribute to the Banana Splits.
Nice.
Partly. Hey, bananas, we think you're groovy. And Massachusetts loves it. You're coming in from Massachusetts, Boston?
Yeah, Boston area. I'm in Billerica, Massachusetts.
Okay, you're coming in from Chachula Prep country.
I'm sorry?
You're coming in from Chachula Prep country.
Absolutely. Breakfast with the Beatles. Yeah, he's awesome.
He's on every Saturday and Sunday. He's got a fantastic show. You're obviously a great fan of the show.
Absolutely. He's on ZLX and... I know he was on WBCN for a long time, and he did stuff with Charles Lacadera, and they did some TV shows together. He's an institution around here.
He had a show called Your Mother's on the Roof.
Oh, I love that show. There was an episode that I downloaded with Shake the Faith, a local band that's really good.
Yeah, amazing. And as I said, he's on Seaside Oldies, and he comes in on a Saturday there, and he comes in on a Sunday night, and he plays the best Beatles songs. So to you, Chachi, we salute you from Plastic
Kid,
Greg. Now, let's move on to your music, Greg. You're doing a project called New Ghost Project. Tell me about that.
Well, I'm in a band called Pop Gun. It's a local band. We've been together off and on for like 27 years. And we took... a year off, one of our guys decided he didn't want to do it anymore. And he came back a year later. But during that time, I decided I probably should get going on some of my own stuff. I did a project like 10 years earlier with a friend of mine, Mark Rockauer, called The Precious Few, where we did some originals that we did in the early 80s in the club scene. And so I decided I wanted to record again. And I went to Woolly Mammoth Sound in Waltham, Massachusetts. And that's headed up by David Minihan, who probably not a world famous guy, but he should be. He's in a band called The Neighborhoods, and they were a huge Boston band for many years. And he's toured with the Replacements. He's their new guitar player. So he's got some major cred. And I recorded three songs there, and they came out really great. And I just went in recently to do another three. They're still in progress. And I've done some home stuff too. But just, you know, releasing tracks as they're finished type of thing.
Play me your best original song. Let's say that's poppy or rock that you reckon's great. Let's hear it.
Oh, you want to? Okay. Yep.
What's it called?
Rock and Roll.
Okay.
This is a song called Mr. Fix It. Mr. Fix It. I just want to qualify this that I'm a drummer who plays guitar. Not a guitar player, really. So
that's cool.
Here we go. Mr. Fix It. Mr. Fix It. Mr. Fix It. Mr. Fix It, you're really all right. You ain't a drug, you're not a drink, not a ghost in the corner with a knowing wink. It's inside that makes us strong. If you're so right, then you can't be wrong. I mean it so sincerely. You're my best friend and it's plain to see that without you being misery, it's to fix it, please stay with me. But sing it! Just to fix it, can't fix anything. Let it out, start to sing. Take a bad day, make it right. Mr. Fix It, you're out of sight. And if you feel you can't go on, just sing this song. It'll fix you like you never, ever, ever can lose. Mr. Fix It, I thank you. I feel so free, like I'm diving from a tree, like there isn't any bottom, and there's no top. I don't ever wanna stop. Mr. Fix It can fix anything.
Mr. Fix It.
Yeah.
Thank you, man. It's so great. It's like, how can I tell you? I can hear a bit of the Kinks in there. I can hear a bit of everything.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Big Kinks fan here. Yeah,
it's
absolutely.
Not like I'm fixing a hole and the rain comes in, right? This is like Mr. Fix It. Yeah, I dig it. I like
it. It's all catchy.
You recorded that with a full band?
Well, that's the thing. There really isn't an official band. I go in the studio. And we put down the click tracks and backing tracks and everything, and I put a guide guitar down and guide vocals, and then I do the real drum tracks, yeah, and then we build it up from there. And you know, I play guitar on it, and my son played bass. My son Dylan, who's done a lot of instruments on this project, and my the guitar player from Pop Gun, Jim, came in to do a lot of guitar. So I bring people in as I'm building up the tracks. So there's different people. On him, David Minihan, the guy I mentioned, he plays the main guitar on this track, which was quite an honor. He started just playing it, and I said, you know, dude, if you want to do it, that's okay by me.
Can I ask you, is the song fully finished?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Is it? Where can I find it?
It's on Bandcamp right now, Greg Walsh's new Ghost Bandcamp. And I probably will do like a Spotify CD release once I have maybe 10 songs. I'm up to four right now. What's that?
It's got to go on Spotify.
Yeah, Spotify, yeah.
Excuse me, and iTunes. Spotify and iTunes, get it out there.
Absolutely.
And I'd like to hear the finished thing.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely. It's on Bandcamp. You can get it there, and you can buy it there, and it's had some sales, and it's gotten a lot of airplay. Thanks to our friend Joe Viglione.
Can you play the chords again? I want to sing along to it.
You got G?
Yeah, just play a bit.
I want E minor?
Sing. Yeah, just play a bit. I want to sing it.
What's that? I'm sorry?
Just play a bit. I'm going to sing a verse.
Okay, go.
Mr. Fix It, you're groovy, yeah. Mr. Fix It, you're phony, yeah. Come and fix my puppy, my sink. Mr. Fix It, you want a drink. Mr. Fix It, you're the man. Ah, oh, Mr. Fix It, fix it if you
Excellent.
Can, yeah. I like it.
Nice.
It's got that groove going, seriously. It's like, I hear it in my head. Da-da-da-da.
Yeah,
it's not bad. It's great. It's a groovy.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I appreciate that.
I know something that's groovy. That's groovy.
I'll take your word for it.
My head now already. What's another one that's groovy?
I'll play. I'm working on a cover in the studio right now, and I'll do a partial version of it.
Yeah, play a bit.
I just went in to record it a few weeks ago, and it's by a local band that broke up in the 80s around here called the New Models. And they were a great, great band. We used to go see them live all the time. They were on their way up. They backed up the Cars at the Boston Garden. They were really just doing some great things. And but they gave up in 85. But what I always admired about them when I saw them live was that they had their hit songs, the local hit songs, and some really strong different types of songs. But they also had, like, it's hard to describe, but like these songs that are really good, that are not their best songs, but if they weren't in the set, you'd really miss it. You know, there was no fat in the set. It was just all good stuff. So this song was very kind of obscure. And I didn't have to, but I asked the guy, Casey Lindstrom, if I could record it because it never was released. And he said, why would you want to record this song? You know, because it wasn't their hit. But I just saw something in it that I really just attracted me to it.
Sure. Let's hear a bit.
So this is a song called Meet Your Maker.
Well, I heard you say, live fast, die young, and that's the only way you can live. Well, I know it's a better world to try. Don't ask me why. You wanna get around, gotta get in gear. If not now, sooner or later. While you're running away, you might meet your maker. Running free, you might meet your maker. Running free, oh, you might be. You might meet your maker. Meet your maker. Meet your maker.
Very nice. I want to hear another original from you.
Oh, I don't have one ready. I just sort of.
Can you play me
on
a bit of one? Just play me a bit of one.
What?
Just play me a bit of one of your originals. Another song.
Let me see here. Let me see.
God, I'm a fallen angel, crying at my wings.
I really don't remember it. Sorry. I just went into the studio a few weeks ago, put down the track, but yeah, that's all I'm prepared to do.
It's not from you, which is good. The original ones are the ones you're not thinking about. You just do them.
Yeah, true. Exactly right. I heard you have quite a song catalog yourself.
About 2,000 songs, but I don't talk about it.
That's awesome.
Hey, Bananas, I think you're groovy. Came to me while I was having a bath. So I'm lying in the bath and these words come to me. Hey, Bananas, we think you're groovy. So that proves two things. You can write a song anywhere and you can stay clean in the meantime.
There you go. Absolutely. Absolutely.
And I'll tell you what, I got some obscure songs. I did an album in Australia. There's the Beatles album called With the Beatles.
Oh, okay.
So what I did is I wanted to challenge myself. So this is how I did it. I wrote down every song that they had on the album, just the song title. And I wrote the opposite title to the song. And then I said, I'm going to write a song about the titles. And I just did a whole album. So I called it with the EPs as a stir on the Beatles. Like, I'll give you an example. You know that song, George Harrison, Don't Bother Me?
Of course.
I wrote one called Please, Please, Please Annoy Me. Right? The opposite. Get it?
I like it. How about I Want to Hold Your Hand? Did you do that one?
Nah, because that wasn't on the album, but I'm trying
to say. That was on the Beatles?
I did some really great songs that thought, I'll do it as like a comedy and see what happens. But the funny thing is some of those songs are really good. If you take out that comedy element, they're really good songs. So what I'm trying to say to you is, subconsciously, when you can just write a song and you don't care if it's good or bad, and you do 10 of them, you'll see that your mind opens up. There's no Nothing's stopping your creativity.
That's
You'll
true.
Be amazed the kind of songs you can do. I did an album once, right, because I test myself. And what I did is I put down 10 songs, but then I put them in reverse. I did a whole album of the songs reversed.
Okay.
Like nothing you've never heard. Just to say, I did it.
I love it. I love it. Excellent.
That's great. Now, you've got to tell me more about this new Ghost project.
Yeah. Like I said, I just went back in and did 3 more songs. Just have the basics done right now with scratch vocals. And my son Dylan and I are going to go back in February and add to it. I think they'll probably be out in a couple of months. Cool. I want to try to do this a little quicker than I did it before. I kind of labored over the first 3 songs, maybe a little too long. There's a song that I released called June Gloom, which a guy named Derek Hughes just did a video for in Florida for me. And that's up on YouTube. Greg Walsh's new Ghost, June Gloom. Very proud of it. It's a lyric video, but it has photos and little movie things in there. And it's kind of cool.
You know what song I listen to every day? It's just like, this is what I'm talking about, right?
Yep.
Bob Dylan, Like a Rolling Stone.
Great song. Great song.
I listen to it on purpose. And it just comes out of his mind.
Yep.
And it's like, it sounds like it's not, you know, like you listen to it and it's just so great. And the greatness is in the simplicity of the song. That's what it is. The simplest songs are the best.
My favorite song of his is It's All Over Now, Baby Blue. That's so haunting. So great.
Now, listen, you've got to tell me, you used to play in some other bands.
Yeah.
Tell me a bit about that. And also tell me where they can find you everywhere, all the links and all that.
Sure. Some of these bands, one of them, Neon, this is a band called Neon Tan that I was in the 80s. If we can get that up there. And the guy in the middle there is my friend Mark. And we were in the Precious Few before this. Precious Few never recorded anything at that time because we didn't really have the budget. And then about 10 years ago, Mark and I hooked up, and he still lives in Florida, but we did it digitally. He did it at a studio in Florida. I did it here, and he flew up here a couple of times to kind of do some stuff in person. And so we have this CD over here, The Precious Few, New Waves.
And, yeah, just bring it close and tell us where they can buy it. Up a
they
bit.
They can buy it. You can get it on Amazon, any place really. It was very heavily promoted. Very proud of this CD more than maybe of a lot of things I've done because I felt like we did it right. We we played with the click tracks. You know what I mean? We made sure everything was even. I'm a little bit of a perfectionist that way. I don't like going in the studio and doing the trying to do the lightning in the bottle thing, because I think it rarely happens in the studio because you're in separate rooms, you don't see each other, and you know everything that I've done in the past, we've done this live thing, and then the guitar players go in and change their tracks anyway, and the only guy who can't change them is me, the drummer. So I kind of like having the option to do 4, 5, 6 takes. Take the best one or take the best bits from each one and just have it be right. I feel like the studio songs should be as well produced as they can be, you know, and then live is of course a different thing.
Of course, as I said, everyone comes in and has got their different take on making their music.
Right.
That's what makes the music unique. Can't knock people the way they want to do it. Everyone's got their way of doing things. Like, I don't want to say too much, but me, I'm more spontaneous, because when I record the song once, I don't want to do 2 takes. I want to do it in 1 if I can do it. And if I do it, I know it might be 80% perfect or 95% perfect, but that one time that I do it has captured the song. The more times I do it, it makes the song different. If I recorded one song 10 times, I can guarantee you it's going to be something different. Like, I'll give you an example.
Yep.
If you go on the net, iTunes, Spotify, YouTube, I got a YouTube channel log case called Plastic EP, one word. PlasticEP, one word. If you go there, I did a song called Let's Buy Some Bubble Gum, okay?
I've heard that.
That is the 60s right there, and I can tell you, the song was done in one take.
As a full band?
In a bottle, because it can't be done again. It cannot be done again. If I had to go back in the studio and do it, it's not going to happen. That's right. Just like, those kind of songs just happen. You're lucky enough, you got it.
Yeah, you know, you sound a lot like my bandmates in Pop Gun. They like to do the lightning in the bottle thing, like you mentioned. And I don't know. Personally, I just think the studio is such an unnatural place. You know what I mean? It's acoustically.
Yeah, I totally understand.
Yeah,
but yeah. I record at home. Most people now recording at home.
So right, you don't have the clock going.
I'll come out in my pajamas and I'll sing and I won't care. And then my wife's in the kitchen, and this is what I normally do. I go, I got a song you're going to sing on it. She goes, okay, can I hear the song? I said, don't worry about it. I said, this is what I want you to do, just sing it. And she just sings it, and she's done it for so many years that here's the song or not, she just likes hear a bit, and I tell her what to do. You know, like I write a song. I'll give you an example, right? It's called The Big E's. It's a tribute to the Everly Brothers. Check it out, The Big E's. Okay. THG /BIG. / the letter E apostrophe little s, the big E's. So this song came out so powerful, right? And I said, I want you to sing in the middle of the track. I want you to go up the scale. So I did the scale with her three times. She nailed it. If she did it on her own, she wouldn't know what to do.
So on that, is your wife the one in that video with you at the beginning?
Yeah, of course. She's singing on the song.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah.
She sings on the song, and as I said, that's something we went to the Hollywood Walk of Stars, the Hollywood Boulevard, just to record that song, Hey Bananas, Think You're Groovy. And I'll tell you, the US love it. It's like, I can't do that again. This is what this show's about, because you got a show, but you got the right song. You got something different that's unique. That's what makes the show, the uniqueness. Right. The song, me, who's on. It's all this. It's not one thing. That's the uniqueness. I mean, I went to Los Angeles, and I got the biggest limousine, and I'm dressed in the gold jacket, my famous gold jacket, with these glasses, right?
Yeah.
Because the glasses are the same ones with the jacket, but now the jacket's a little bit small, right? Because I've had it, like, for 30 years or whatever.
Yeah.
So, anyway, I'm in this huge limousine, and we're going to Amoeba Records to buy records, and I go to the guy at the front, the limo driver, I said, do I look normal? He goes, oh, yeah, you fit right in.
Definitely in L.A., definitely.
And actually, I'm walking down the street there, and people are looking at me like, what is this? Or who is this?
If you're looked at in L.A., that's a good thing.
Yeah, I know. It's great. I mean, I just fit right in. It doesn't bother me. And now it's like this shirt. I've got a white shirt with black, same shirt, but they love the black shirt.
Yeah,
the white shirt doesn't cut it. It's like the great thing, whatever you do in your life, like that first song, I can tell you now, you'd be proud of that song because it's a great song. I'm telling you, it's a great song.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, tell them all your links. And Greg, I wish you all the best because you're on the
track.
You.
Thank you. So basically, like I said, any of the old CDs. I wanted to show you one thing.
Yeah, go
this
for
is,
it.
The Boston Rock and Roll Anthology 15.
Yes, hold that up. And let's see. Go back a little bit. Go back a little bit. Back a little bit. And down a bit. Stop right there. Yep. Up.
That's the first CD that I was on with Joe Vig. And I was in a band called Huck 2 at the time. And we had a song called Packy Run. And that was on this one. So I was with Joe in 93. And now here we are again in 2020. Pretty cool.
I'll tell you what, any other links they need to go to?
I would say the new Ghost thing is pretty active right now. My band Pop Gun, you know, definitely on hiatus from gigging, obviously with what's going on in the world right now. But we're very close to getting back to rehearsing. We're all feeling a little safer about that. And I think we'll do some recording. Our guitar player has a homemade studio. I think we'd like to do some of that stuff, maybe put out a Facebook video or something. But I miss the guys. I haven't seen them for months. You know, the new Ghost Project, like I said, I go in and I record with David Minihan, and then I just bring people in as I need them and build up the track slowly like that. So it's fun.
Take us out with a verse and chorus from Mr. Fix It. I got to hear it again.
All right. An encore.
And then say goodbye to everyone and we'll call it a great interview.
Mr. Fix-It can fix anything. Let it out, start to sing. Take a day, make it right. Mr. Fix-It, you're out of sight. Mr. Fix-It can fix anything.
Thank you very much, Plastic.
Hey, I really loved it. That song's a groove. I'm still singing. I'll be singing it today. Thanks again, Greg. It's been my pleasure.
My pleasure as well. Thank you, sir. Take care.
Anytime.